Linux systems and kernel programming. Before going to the Linux systems, we need to know little about history of computer. What is computer? It's a machine or hardware. That machine contains CPU, memory devices, input output devices. CPU and memory devices will be inside the system unit. Remaining speaker, keyboard, mouse, microphone, monitor and screen, we can say it's input output devices. All computers will be called in terms of generations. Every generation of computer is characterized by major technological development that changed the way of computer. From 1940s to present day, the major development was shown on the computer, like become smaller in size, cheaper and more efficient. Will be discussed one by one in the next slides. Computer invented by Charles Babbage. He was alive between 1791 to 1871. He got in first idea to design programmable machine. His machines we can call as mechanical computing engines. You can see his image in the right side, and you can see one of the part of computer in the back side of him. Even though you may get doubt, the computer was generations was started in 1940s, but he was developed the computer in 1833. We didn't call the generations from 1833 because of lack of development and technology. First generation of the computer starts in 1940s to 1956. The first generation of the computer used vacuum tubes for the circuitry and the magnetic drums for the memory and taking up big rooms. It was very expensive to operate and uses a great amount of electricity and produced large amount of heat. The first generation of the computer relied on machine level language, which can understand by the only the systems like computers and do or perform some functions and operations. It can solve only one problem at a time. It cannot do any multitasking work. The input was based on punch cards. What is my punch cards? Also called as IBM cards, holes may be punched using hand or machine. You can see the right side top pic, punch card in punch card machine. The holes will be punching like this, and you can see the punched card as example in the below pic. Cards were fed into the card reader connected to the computer. For example, if you have 10 lines of code and one line is going to take one punch card, and we need to arrange in a stack of cards connected to the computer to convert the sequence of holes into digital information to understand by the system. Second generation of the computer. Here the evolution was started with the transistors. Transistors were used in second generation of the computer, and transistors were replaced by vacuum tubes. The first transistor was invented in 1947, but didn't use in the computer till 1950. Transistors are superior to the vacuum tubes because due to transistors, computer becomes smaller, cheaper and faster. It is very reliable than first generation of the computers. Transistors were also produced the large amount of heat subjected to the computer to damage. But compared to the last generation, in this generation, there is a lot of improvement in cooling system also. The input was based on the punched cards and paper tapes, and outputs are displayed on printouts, like same as first generation. The second generation of the computer moved to assembly level language from binary machine level language. This language allowed programmers to specify input or instructions in words. High level programming languages were also developed at the same time. The first computer of the second generation was developed for the atomic energy industry. You can see the paper tapes here, how they are inserting into the machine and how to understand the letters. You can see in the last pic. Third generation. Third generation starts in 1964 to 71. Here we can say in a single word, integrated circuits. The integrated circuits were used in the third generation of the computer. Transistors were placed on a silicon chip known as semiconductors, which increases the speed and the efficiency of the computer. In this third generation of the computer, user used the keyboards and monitors and interfaced with an OS, we can say operating system, instead of punched cards and printouts. So here the evolution was started with operating system. In this generation, the computer can run many applications at one time. this generation of the computer is small and cheaper and reliable than the first generation, second generation. Operating system. It is a system software that is collection of system programs which acts as an interface between user and hardware. And OS also acts as an interface between programs and hardware. We'll be discussing about more about operating system in future videos. Fourth generation starts in 1971 to 2010. Here also we can say in single word microprocessor. Microprocessor brought in fourth generation of the computers. Thousands of integrated circuits were built on single chip. The generation of the computer occupies entire room like first generation, but now the fourth generation of the computer fit in a single table or palm, or we can say by using laptops in the labs. The first time, the 1971, the Intel chip was developed and used in the computers. Along with CPU and memory, lot of input output devices were added like mouse and printers, and started using graphical user interfaces to understand by the users. And fifth generation starts in 2010 to still. The fifth generation of the computer is based on artificial intelligence and still in development. There are many applications which are used in these generations, like voice recognition, which is being used today. The supercomputers nanotechnologies are used to make AI systems reality. The goal or target of this generation is to develop the devices that responds to natural languages. We can see our laptops which will control out through our voice recognitions. We have observed all five generations. All five generations of the computer and advances of the technology that lead to the development of many devices which everybody uses today. Our computer journey started in 1940 and ended and goes on to the AI artificial intelligence system which we'll use today. Thank you. We'll be seeing the next video with introduction to Unix systems.